Hi everyone, in this tech vid, I'll show you how to automate deployment of Sophos Central Endpoint to Windows devices. There are multiple ways to deploy Sophos Central Endpoint. These include manual installation of software on the endpoint, triggering installation through a startup or login script via Active Directory group policy, and using Intune or System Center Configuration Manager, also known as SCCM. Today, I'll use the Active Directory method. The steps for Intune or SCCM deployment are also available in the listed documentation, so refer to that for further information. I'll cover how to download the Sophos Central Endpoint Windows installer, how to create and deploy a batch script, and alternatively, how to create and deploy a PowerShell script. The steps I'll cover are also found in the Knowledge Base article linked in the description, so refer to that for more information. Before starting, there are a few things to keep in mind. If you plan to use a login script, the login user must have administrator privileges, as this is required to run the installer. I'll be using a startup script, so this won't be required. Prior to installation, ensure the following software packages are not installed on the endpoints, or the installation will fail: Sophos Patch, Sophos Client Firewall, and Sophos Antivirus if Web Control, Data Control, or Application Control are enabled on the computer. If a device control policy has been applied, Sophos Antivirus uninstallation requires a restart to unload the kernel driver sdcfilter.sys. We also recommend removing any third-party antivirus software that may be installed. The Sophos Competitor Removal tool will run as part of the installation and try to remove certain detected software packages. This is done using the recorded uninstall string from the registry and may fail if additional protections similar to that of tamper protection are turned on. If your current antivirus includes features that will prevent uninstallation, it's best to turn the feature off. Next, all devices must have an active internet connection. In addition, make sure to allow all traffic to the domains and ports required for communication to and from Sophos Central. Refer to the linked documentation for further information. If you have devices to protect that cannot be connected to the internet directly, refer to our documentation on update caches, also linked in the description. Let's get started. First, download the Sophos Central Endpoint Installer from the Sophos Central dashboard that will manage your endpoints. Do not use a user-specific installer received via email deployment. If you do, all devices will become associated with the Sophos Central user that received the email. Under My Products, go to Endpoint, Installers. If you plan to use a batch script, select Download Complete Windows Installer. Make sure the file is saved to a location you can easily find later. On the other hand, if you plan to use a PowerShell script, you only need the download link address. Note, while this says Complete Windows Installer, this is actually a thin installer that deploys all features available depending on your license. When you run the installer, it connects to Sophos Central, checks your license, and downloads the necessary software. As mentioned before, your devices must have an active internet connection, and all traffic to the domains and ports required for communication with Sophos Central must be allowed. Now, I can proceed with deployment, starting with the batch script. If you wish to use a PowerShell script instead, skip ahead in this tech vid. The batch or .bat script will call this installer. So copy the downloaded installer into a shared folder accessible to all the devices that need it. Adjust the sharing permissions of the folder if required. Next, create a new text document. Paste the script provided in the KB article. Again, this is linked in the description. Copy the location of the folder containing the installer. Amend the line that starts with push D and paste in the location. Save the file as sophoscentralendpointinstall.bat and temporarily place it somewhere you can easily find. Now, let's deploy the script via Active Directory GPO. To do so, I can either create a new group policy or edit an existing one. I'll demonstrate how to create a new one. First, navigate to the Group Policy Management console. Open the Run command, type gpmc.msc and press OK. Now, locate the organizational unit where you need to deploy the Sophos Central endpoint. Right-click on this and select Create a GPO in this domain and link it here. Enter a GPO name, for example, Sophos Central Windows Endpoint Deployment Policy. Click OK. Right-click on the new GPO and choose Edit. This opens the Group Policy Management Editor window. Under Computer Configuration, go to Policies, Window Settings, Scripts, Startup, Shutdown. On the right panel, double-click Startup to view its properties. Click Show Files. This will open the File Explorer in the location where the GPO will run the script. Now, find the batch script we previously created. Copy this and paste it here. Go back to the Startup Properties window. Click Add, then Browse. I now see the directory which contains the batch file I just pasted. Select the file and click Open. Press OK to add the script. Finally, click Apply, then OK. Now, return to the Group Policy Management window and select the Sophos Central Windows Endpoint Deployment Policy GPO. In the Scope tab, ensure that the length contain the correct OU. In Security Filtering, check that your target user group is listed. If the user group isn't there, click Add to include them. Next, I need to enforce the deployment of the new GPO. Right-click on the OU, then select Group Policy Update. Click Yes to proceed. If you need to force an update of the GPO, open Command Prompt on one of the target endpoints and run the command gpupdate/force. Then, reboot the computer. The batch script will run automatically to install Sophos Central Endpoint. Now, I'll show you how to deploy using a PowerShell script. First, create a PS1 file. Open a text editor such as Notepad and paste the text provided in the Knowledge Base article. The article is linked in the description. Edit line 3 to include your specific download link. Then, save the file as Sophos Central Endpoint Install.ps1, choosing a location that you can easily find, such as the desktop. Now, I can deploy to an endpoint using the new script. Navigate to the Group Policy Management console. Open the Run window. Type gpmc.msc and press OK. For non-server devices, specifically Windows 11, you may need to enable this feature under Windows Settings, Apps, Optional Feature. Look for RSAT, Group Policy Management and Console, then Install. This will enable the feature on your Windows 11 devices. Once the Management Console is open, right-click on the organizational unit you need to deploy to. Then select Create a GPO in this domain and link it here. Enter a GPO name, for example, Sophos Central Windows Endpoint Deployment. Right-click on the new GPO and select Edit to open the Group Policy Management Editor. Under Computer Configuration, go to Policies, Window Settings, Scripts, Startup, Shutdown. On the right panel, double-click Startup to view its properties. Go to the PowerShell Scripts tab and click Show Files. This will open the File Explorer in the location where the GPO will run the script. Copy the PS1 script to this folder. Now, go back to the Startup Properties window. Click Add, then Browse. I now see the directory which contains the PS1 file I just added. Select the file and click Open. Press OK to add the script. Finally, click Apply, then OK. Now, return to the Group Policy Management window and select the Sophos Central Windows Endpoint Deployment Policy GPO. In the Scope tab, ensure that the links contain the correct OU. In Security Filtering, check that your target user group is listed. If the user group isn't there, click Add to include them. Next, I need to force the deployment of the new GPO. Right-click on the OU, then select Group Policy Update. Click Yes to proceed. To test the GPO, open command prompt on one of the devices and run the command gpupdate/force. Then restart the computer. The software will install automatically. And that completes the steps to automate software deployment for Sophos Central Endpoint on Windows devices. I hope you found this video useful. Check out the documentation for this tech vid in the description. For further assistance, view and post questions on community.sophos.com and go to techvids.sophos.com for more great videos like this one.